Okay, a bit of celebrity gossip, which I normally don't do, but since some of you asked me, it seems that some of the news that I read, some of you also read. So just thought, if you have the common interest, fine. I want to speak about what is that? Lily Singh, her show got cancelled after 2 seasons. Then Logan Paul going to fight Floyd Mayweather. Then Tyron Woodley is going to fight Jake Paul. Okay, just thought, okay, I'll give you my thoughts on these. And yes, Conor McGregor also going to have a fight. So I watch MMA and boxing sometimes here and there. So I thought I'll give you my thoughts about all this. Okay, so in no particular order. First one is Lily Singh. Lily Singh, after 2 seasons, her show was cancelled, thankfully. I'm not a fan of hers. Like, I remember 6 or 7 years ago when someone told me, hey, Lily Singh, or six, or yeah, something on that. Check this superwoman and all that. I checked her content. It was not my kind of thing. Like, I really didn't connect to it. I didn't relate to it. Then again, when Lily Singh had The Rock featured with her, like, fuck, she must have hit it big time. That time it was a mystery why Rock collaborated with her, but then I understood. Rock was collaborating with Logan Paul and all these influencers to boost his social media ranking. And he's a very smart guy. He does whatever he does with a purpose. So Lily Singh had a different demographic, millions of followers and all that, so he gets a boost in his ranking. And she targets the LGBTQ community, and her humor and her content is for all these kiddies who say sex, sex, oh, vagina, vagina, ooh, ah, and they feel happy. And not my kind of thing, sorry. I'm not saying she's not successful. She is exceptionally successful, rich beyond, another 1,000 lifetimes, I'll not be able to reach where she is. I give credit where credit is due. She is an author of a book. And however, what I'm telling you is her content is not my kind. It's not my kind of thing. Now, her show got cancelled. If you check her humor, I'm a brown woman of color or a bisexual woman of color. That is her joke, and ha ha ha, fake laughter. I don't know, man. I really don't understand why people are faking it. In fact, if you check Rotten Tomatoes, her ratings by critics was 86% and audience gave her some 16% or something. And next, second season, critics didn't bother, zero. Nobody responded. And her rating is still lousy, 16. That means everyone just put their positive rating because they just didn't want a backlash from the LGBTQ community. They wanted to show, we support people of color, we support the Indians who are wannabe Goras. Now, yes, she is a very successful YouTuber, 15 million views, and she's a very successful, she transitioned into mainstream media, TV, late night show, and she wrote a book and all. But however, her success is only YouTube. Her success everywhere else is a failure because it has not been consistent. Her talk show is dead. Anyway, it was bound to happen. It's only a question of when. Her book is, if you check the reviews, again, rubbish. I'm pretty sure she had a marketing team to put positive reviews. Like I said, her content is not my kind. And she's not a comedian. Her content is more like this Logan Paul, Jake Paul, attention grabbing, you feel happy, you enjoy comedy, you know, I'm an Indian, haha, my mother acts like this, father acts like this, Indian, Canadians like it. But now the thing is, when you are in your 20s and 30s, it's cute to do all this. When you reach your 40s and 50s, it's no longer cute. I don't know what is Lily Singh's age, but once she moves into being 40-year-old, don't expect 20-year-olds or teenagers to like your content. They'll be like, who's this old lady? You know, when you have a small child, think a small baby, singing a song which is out of tune, ah, la, 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 you feel it's cute. Okay, the kid grows up to be a young school going boy and girl, la, 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 it's cute, yeah. But once you become a grown ass, a teen or the thing, if you sing like that, they'll be like, you need to work on yourself. And then when you become an adult, yes, it may bring some X Factor fame, like that guy who sang, she bangs, it sounds funny, but more than one person does it, the novelty wears off. And yes, you can be funny that one time, but what will you do the second time? Consistency is the key. Becoming a viral sensation and then dropping off the map, you'll just live the next 50 years of your life talking of your time of being famous. Lily Singh's challenge is to reinvent herself. She's on the decline. Her time is up. As you become older, when you become 40 and when you cross into that, people don't find you funny and cute anymore. They just don't. And you're just going to lose your subscriber base. See, everybody has that. Whether it's an actor, whether it's an actress, whether it's a singer, even me. That is why, do you think I didn't, the person that I was in my 20s, changed when I was in my 30s, or girls, and I used to literally do crazy stuff. Today, I'm looking more towards, okay, 40 to 60, what do I need to do? I'm moving towards that direction. Age catches up, you can't be, it's no longer cute, whether you're a girl or a guy. You can reinvent yourself up to a certain point, after which it becomes a joke. Like Madonna, who's in her 60s, posting photographs of her in a bathtub and heavily photoshopped and heavily makeup face. It's so obvious, you're a grandma. What are you doing? If you check her photographs without Photoshop and makeup, she is actually a grandma, her face is sagging. But if you see her photographs online, they look so amazing, tight. Even Jennifer Lopez looks amazing. She'll wear these tight outfits where even her, camel toe, outline of her vagina is shown. You think she's not aware of this? You think she doesn't know this when someone's taking a photo? Kim Kardashian showing her bum and breasts and sometimes holding like this and taking a photo in the mirror. What is all this? How many times will you see a person naked? You'll see the opening in between their legs. You'll see their hanging breasts. But if there is no filter, there's no Photoshop, there's no touch-up, there's no makeup. We all have hanging skin. We all have ugly-looking body parts. This what they show online, not reality, man. So Lily Singh is anyway going to go on a decline. Her time is up. That's at least my prediction. You can tell me if I'm right or wrong. So that's as far as Lily Singh goes. She was good as long as she was good. Now, I believe, this is my prediction, her decline has started. Now, it'll be smart for her to get into either doing something new, serious, which matches her age, or move into some kind of business, the side. But her primary audience, her YouTube channel followers, they are going to get fed up and tired. And I don't think her subscriber base will come down, but her viewership per video will not be what it used to be in the peak days. That much I can assure you. So you can tell me if I'm right or wrong. So this is my prediction for Lily Swing.
Jesus. Hello there. It's me, Jesus Christ, speaking to you from heaven. All right, you? Yeah, you, my friend. Yeah, you. Look, you prayed to me every single day, and you told me, like, I want a better paying job, and I want to, like, change my life, and I want to be happy. Well, look, here's your answer. Contact my buddy, Loy Macedo, of loymacedo.com, and he will do the needful. Well, okay. Maybe he looks like the devil. Maybe a little scary, you know, the tattoos and slightly horrible, but like, trust me, like, okay, he looks terrible, right, but don't worry, he's a cool guy. So what are you waiting for? Google him. Google his name. Contact him. Yeah, and you'll see why I sent you. Yeah, he's the real deal. And yes, my child, you'll find the answer. You know, this is the part where you stop staring at me and contact the guy. All right. Trust me. Go on now. I got other things to do around here, all right?